Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. This is the 1010 Club. My name is Jonah, and normally we are down in my basement if you've seen previous videos. Today, we're out in the yard. We're redoing the basement. I might actually have some walls in a few weeks, but I still want to check out this Bulova Oceanographer, or as we all like to call it, the Devil Diver. The Devil Diver reissue has been out for a few years, and there's been more than a few reviews of it on YouTube, but I just bought one, so I'm gonna make one too. It is gonna be a little different though, because I don't wanna just parrot what other reviews have already covered. Plus, disregarding the sticker price, which is just a little absurd, now is the absolute best time to buy one of these. Their price, even new, even from an authorized dealer, is at its absolute lowest. So let's jump in. I'm going to cover the three details about this watch that I feel have widely been overlooked in other reviews. Then we're going to see the three most popular thoughts about this watch and whether or not they're actually as important as I thought they would be before I swipe my credit card. On paper, these proportions are a little wacky, but they do all work together in near perfect harmony. It's like a fantastic magic trick that Bulova pulled off. I'll cover more of that later. The first detail about this watch that I feel like gets overlooked too often is the simple fact that the Devil Diver is actually a certified diver. The nearly fully polished case and bracelet, the jewel-like hour markers, and the overall retro vibe of this watch kind of belie the fact that this is an ISO-certified dive watch. It is a tool watch, and I especially have a soft spot for fancier looking things that are secretly tough, like this watch and like I'd like to believe I am, and the Devil Diver checks this box big time. The second is the bracelet. The stamped clasp has been very well covered, but there's a few other details I think that can be helpful to know, like that this president style bracelet is actually 5 links instead of 3. It's a little confusing until you look closer. The center link is brushed, but then there are 2 high polished links on either side of that brushed link. Grand Seiko has been doing this recently too, and it's a little confusing. Does the single line separating the 2 polished links offer enough design interest to warrant 5 links over 3? Maybe. And the design is carried through on the end links, which is nice, but either way, I thought it was an interesting detail to learn. I wanted to pass it on to you. Second, and this is definitely more on the objectively negative side, but the fold-over clasp is, to put it lightly, horrendous. Maybe it's just my specific model, but at least 40% of the time, if not more, I can't open the clasp, the fold-over clasp. I can't get it up with my fingernail. It feels stuck, and I can overlook a stamped clasp, but literally not being able to operate a bracelet, major letdown. Third, as I briefly mentioned earlier, is the price. I mean, every video recognizes that the $800 sticker price has always been marked down, even on Bulova's official website. But now, in 2023, this model is severely marked down. I bought this one brand new from an authorized dealer for literally 50% off, so just under $400 USD. And I probably could have found it new for less, too. On eBay, these are selling kind of in the mid-300s, so now is a great time to buy if you're interested. Number 3.5, if I can sneak one in, is something that gets mentioned a lot, but I just want to give it my own personal shout out. It's the italic snorkel on the dial above the 6 o'clock. It might be my favorite detail about this whole watch. There's something refreshingly realistic about saying snorkel instead of diver, because we know we're not going to go diving. Also, though, it's kind of humble in the restraint because it is a certified diver, so they could if they wanted to, but they didn't. And I guess this is kind of obvious because it's a reissue, but it's so satisfyingly retro to see that snorkel, especially in that font. I absolutely love it. Okay, the three things that everybody mentions, here's whether or not I think they're important. Number 1, the applied indices. probably the most famous thing about this watch other than the 666 feet on the dial. And yes, they really are that cool. And yes, they look exactly like set jewels. It's a really cool effect, and I love how tall the indices are. The lume is either underneath or in the indices. Either way, also super cool. This watch just isn't this watch, or maybe I should just say it's not nearly as interesting and even maybe a dud if these markers weren't on the dial face. Second is the reverse Cyclops. Like every other review has said, it doesn't really magnify the date by much, but it's cool to have it without having a bump on the top side of the crystal. I wouldn't necessarily mind if it did have that bump. I have a King Turtle with a giant topographical Cyclops, but the undermounted effect is definitely special, but only a little special. Unlike those indices, this watch could not have any Cyclops at all and be totally fine. Third, and probably the most lamented, is the movement. This watch uses an 8000 series Miyota movement, which is roughly the equivalent of Seiko's 7S26, which was made famous by the SKX. It's Miyota's lowest grade movement, even if this is the highest grade of the lowest grade. It doesn't hack, it's not very accurate. I didn't think I would mind it that much. I'm not like a technophile when it comes to watch movements, and I didn't mind it much. I can't really hear the rotor spinning. I didn't really care about the hacking, but I was surprised as the weeks went on. I started to get frustrated. The watch runs pretty fast, like 12 to 15 seconds fast, which isn't so bad, especially with the parameters, but it's enough for someone like me who's weirdly obsessed with keeping their watches very accurate to get annoyed. It feels cheap, especially because Bulova's owned by Citizen, who makes the Miyota movements. They had plenty of access to nicer movements, and there are plenty of watches under $400 that have 9000 series movements, for example. So it is a bummer. Lastly, something that has sort of been covered, but I really want to make sure it is emphasized, is the way this watch wears. It is very, very comfortable on the wrist, and it wears much smaller than 44 millimeters might suggest, even smaller than other 44, 45 millimeter watches that are known for wearing small, like Seiko Turtles. I have two of those. This watch wears much smaller. As far as I can tell, it's due to two things. It's the finishing and the dial design. The high polish case acts as a camouflage of sorts. The reflections distract the eye from seeing the entire cushion case as one whole piece of metal. You only see parts at a time while the other parts are busy acting like a mirror to all the objects around you. It's a really fascinating effect, and it makes the watch feel smaller. Add that to the 20 millimeter bracelet, it's amazing. At first, it does seem disproportionate, especially on paper, not to have a 22 millimeter bracelet, but the way it shrinks the footprint on your wrist is phenomenal. Then there's the dial design. The bezel is only 41.5 millimeters. Then the dial is 31.5 millimeters. Everything gets smaller and smaller. These series of concentric circles is what gives this illusion. The outer bezel to the inner bezel to the circle around the outside of the applied hour markers to the additional inner printed minute markers, every one of those smaller and smaller circles shrinks the dial, and then that inner circle, which is about 22 millimeters wide, is also segmented into four separate parts, so it makes a wonderful illusion that works really well with a larger dial. Do I wish, still, that this watch was a little bit smaller? Yeah, thinner, too. 41 millimeters wide and maybe 12 millimeters thick would make these proportions almost perfect. I'm almost describing the orange colorway, the other Devil Diver. That one is 41 millimeters wide, although I think it's basically just as thick. If that model came on a bracelet like this one does, I would snatch it up in a heartbeat, and honestly, I may still. But this larger version really has made its way into my heart, and I've been kind of on a smaller watch kick recently too, so I think that says a lot. If you can find one of these in the $300, mid $300 range, and you like the way it looks, You will not be disappointed. Thanks as always for hanging out, watching this video, stepping outside of the basement with me today. If you enjoyed the video, or maybe you just are feeling supportive, a subscription down below really helps the channel. Thanks again. I'll see you next time.